To get the Tecla working on Android, you first need to download the Tecla Access app from the Google Play Store. Then you need to pair it to the Android device and connect it to the Tecla Access app, which I'll demonstrate now. With the Tecla Shield ready for pairing with an Android device being in green mode, you're going to go into Settings and select Bluetooth. You'll see Tecla Shield listed here along with a few random numbers at the end. Select the Tecla Shield, and once you see a Bluetooth pairing request, click Pair. And now it will appear under Paired Devices. To connect to the Tecla Access app, which is already downloaded from the Google Play Store, you need to go back to Settings and choose Language and Input. Choose Current Keyboard and select Tecla Access as your keyboard of choice. So now it's your default. Choose Tecla Access under Keyboard and Input Methods and select Connect to Tecla Shield. Now the Tecla Shield has been connected with your device, as you can see by the Tecla icon in the upper left-hand corner. The Tecla navigation menu has now appeared. This is what will allow you to control your device using the Tecla Shield. You select the arrows to move, OK to select, the back arrow to cancel, or the repeat key to move multiple times. Now you can configure the app. You can set your switch actions, the navigation keyboard timeout, or adjust your scanning settings. If you are using a single switch, you can enable self-scanning under Scanning Settings and select a scanning rate. You can see that once this is enabled, the navigation keyboard is scanned automatically. If you like, you can set up inverse scanning so that you press the switch to start the scanning process and let go when you're ready to select. Or turn scanning off if using step scanning with the multiple switches.